There are loads of hills across Edinburgh and the Lothians, but some of them are a wee bit more special than the others. And today, I'm going to give you a bit of an insight into one that you might not have heard about. Now, the most famous hill in East Lothian is going to be Berwick Law. But if you take a 20-minute drive south, you'll find something quite special that's also given up a lot of very precious secrets over the years. Traprain Law is a fascinating site, but I think what makes it more interesting is kind of just how unassuming it looks, because your main view of this hill is really going to be from the motorway, and from there you don't get a sense of the fact that this was really once a thriving Iron Age metropolis. So what was Traprain Law? Well, it was a hill fort. Now, the term hill fort tends to conjure up images of these huge, defensive, impregnable structures, but the term can be a little bit misleading. The fact is that not all hill forts were like that, and Traprain appears to be one of them. The hill fort at Traprain was much more of a settlement, which at its fullest extent reached around about 16 hectares. Now, we have evidence of burials here from round about 1500 BC, with occupation beginning on and off from around about 1000 BC, lasting all the way through to 400 AD. Now, the main group of people that we associate with this site were a group called the Votadini. The Votadini were a Celtic peoples, meaning they spoke a Celtic language, and they controlled territories across southeast Scotland and right the way into northeast England. And they've got important links with some hugely prominent sites across the Lothians, including Cairnpapel Hill in West Lothian, also Castle Hill in the city centre of Edinburgh, and of course, right here at Traprain. During the Roman era, the Votadini became a client kingdom of the empire, acting as a kind of buffer between Rome and, of course, the slightly more hostile groups in the area. And that lasted all the way up until circa 400, when the Romans finally left the British Isles. One of the benefits of being a client kingdom for Rome was essentially just Roman silver. And in 1919, an incredible hoard of over 250 pieces of silver was found at Traprain, and it's still on display in the National Museum of Scotland. It's not just archaeology at Traprain Law, you'll also find a nice surprise when you reach the top. You see, historically there's always been a lot of problems with fire up on the hill. The long dry grasses, hot summers, it's bound to happen. But they've taken a rather interesting approach at dealing with that, and what you'll find up here is 13 Exmoor ponies. Now, their job is to keep the grass short, which means the risk of fire is much, much less. Now, whether it's hill walking or hill forts that you're interested in, there are loads of sites across East Lothian that you will absolutely fall in love with. But if you can't get out and explore yourself, you can always follow us. If you like and subscribe, you can keep up with our adventures around the county.